While the word fairy might make you think of cutesy cartoons, the fairies of folklore were actually known to be blood-sucking vampires. It's only fitting that this whimsical plant, nicknamed fairy lanterns, would be equally life-sapping. And just like fairies, these plants are almost impossible to find. This is our quest for Thismia.
Hi, I'm Tasha the Amazon, and you're watching Floralogic. Today we're talking about an eccentric recluse of a flowering plant that doesn't rely on the sun to survive. Thismia, sometimes called fairy lanterns, are about as hard to find as the mythical creatures they're nicknamed after. Because of this elusivity, and despite being absolutely fascinating, we still don't know much about these tiny wonders.
Thismia, from the family Thismiaceae, is a genus of flowering plant unlike many others. Unlike most other plants, Thismias do not generate their own energy by turning light into fuel. Instead, these plants are what is known as mycoheterotrophic, meaning that they tap all of their energy from fungi that live underground.
There are about 400 species of plants in around 85 genera that are mycoheterotrophic. Another 20,000 species are what's called mixotrophs, which only require the help of fungi at certain stages of their development, like when their seedlings are just getting started in life.
The fungi Thismia prey on are mycorrhizal, meaning that they have a mutually beneficial relationship with green plants whose roots they colonize. Through its photosynthesis, the green plant will give the fungus energy it generates from the sun, and in return, the fungus will give the plant water and minerals that it takes from the soil.
It is exactly this beautiful symbiotic relationship that Thismia exploits, scamming the fungus out of the energy it would normally be given by the plant. It does this by using its own roots to tap into the roots of the fungus, called mycelium, to pull energy out for itself. Because it gives nothing back to the fungus, the Thismia is considered a parasite.
Because they don't make their own energy from photosynthesis, Thismia have no functional leaves and lack the chlorophyll that makes other plants green. Their lack of green color makes them almost translucent, giving the illusion that they light up, hence their fairy lantern nickname.
Without these photosynthesis features, Thismia actually look more like little mushrooms, which just supports the old adage that you are what you eat.
Thismia are only visible poking above the surface when they're flowering or fruiting. And since they don't need to have access to the sun, they're often completely hidden under leaf litter.
This hidden nature adds to their being so difficult to find. Currently, we know of about 80 or 90 species, but because of their elusivity, new species are found almost every year. And these aren't just remote regions that keep churning out new species.
Thismia kinabaluensis was discovered in 2018 on Mount Kinabalu in North Borneo, which is famously one of the most biodiverse tropical regions in the world.
Botanists have been combing over this mountainous region for centuries, so it speaks to the secretive nature of Thismia that we're still finding new species even here.
Southeast Asia, specifically the regions of Borneo, the Malay Peninsula, and Vietnam, is home to a plethora of Thismia species and seems to be the center of the diversity of these species. Thismia can also be found across tropical regions of Australia, South America, and even extended into more temperate regions of Japan, New Zealand, and Australia.
Since they're so specific about which fungus they tap into, most species have a super limited distribution and may even just appear in a single location. More on why this has created one of botany's greatest mysteries later. When we talk about elusivity in nature, we're usually talking about animals that have the ability to hide from detection.
Just like the coelacanth, which was thought to have gone extinct with the dinos 65 million years ago, but was caught off the coast of South Africa as recently as 1938. In the case of plants, elusivity is harder to achieve because unless you're a tumbleweed, you're not going anywhere.
Thismia species, however, have a habit of earning the title most likely to disappear over and over again.
Thismia cubensis was thought to be extinct for over 30 years after its initial discovery in 1992, until it was rediscovered in 2023 in its Japanese homeland.
This species takes a special prize for being the northernmost Asian species of this mostly tropical plant. So its rediscovery has caused quite a stir in botany circles.
Then there's Thismia clavigera, which was believed to be extinct for over a century after it was first discovered in Malaysia in 1865. At the same time, it was named Geometra clavigera because it was thought to belong to a different flowering plant genus. Fast forward over 100 years later when it was rediscovered in Malaysia in 1979.
Over a century had gone by without so much of a glimpse of this plant. But these two are not the only Thismia species that have disappeared without a trace.
The most elusive of all the species of Thismia is the lone North American variety, Thismia americana, which disappeared completely in 1916. At the time when it was discovered, it caused botanical sensation, as nothing like it had ever been seen before in North America. It was first spotted by botanist Norma Pfeiffer in southern Chicago back in 1912. This tiny white flower that just barely peeked over the soil was only ever spotted between early July and mid-September.
For 4 years, Pfeiffer studied this minuscule mystery until it vanished off the face of the earth and was never seen again. It has never been found anywhere else in the world.
Even more strange is that the closest relative of this suburban Chicagoan was thought to be Thismia rodwayi, a native to Australia and New Zealand, over 15,000 kilometers away.
More recent studies, however, have shown that this elusive Japanese species I just mentioned, Thismia cubensis, is actually Thismia americana's closest next of kin. Side note, because of this relationship, new theories about how Thismia crossed over to North America via the Beringia land bridge, as many other plants have in history, are now being investigated.
Repeated attempts to find Thismia americana in the same location it was originally found have come up dry. The running theory is that the environmental impact of the heavy industry of the region caused the extinction of Thismia americana. Some believe that Thismia americana was just an elaborate hoax, albeit one that required a lot of co-conspirators, and one that also hasn't been able to be disproved in over a century.
Many, however, believe that this little mycoheterotrophic mystery is still out there somewhere, hiding in plain sight. This is a call to all you Chicago-based amateur botanists to go on a hunt for this elusive species. Maybe you'll be the first to spot this tiny flowering plant in well over a century and prove that this wasn't a hoax, but the discovery of yet another utterly unique species of Thismia. Or maybe it's just as mythical as the fairies it's nicknamed after. So what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. Bye!
Thanks, Jack! We're back from the studio with more on plants. Take it away, Tasha!
Did you call me Moron Plants?
Yeah. Isn't that the name of the show? Moron Plants.
Yeah, that checks out. This is my velvet alocasia. It is one of my favorite plants. This, my fiddly fig, little known fact, I got this the day we filmed our first Florologic video. Whoa. Look how big it is now. It was just a little man. We have some dragon scale alocasia. As you can see, I like alocasia. These are called dicks, the dick plant. This is a tamarind tree that I'm growing. It's not really tree-like yet, but it's coming. It's coming along. It's real nice. It makes me happy. I killed my pitcher plants this year. I don't know why. They just decided to give up the ghost. Well, we've got some pink princesses hiding in here, as you can see. Check out that pink. Check that out. That's nice, isn't it? I poked myself on my dick cactus.
Oh no! Dick infection!